Here are some stocks to watch out for. We are monitoring shares of Tesla after CEO Elon Musk said shareholders are on track to approve his massive $56 billion pay package. Tesla shares jumped 6% ahead of the Thursday shareholders' vote. Also in focus, shares of Broadcom after the chipmaker topped fiscal second quarter expectations and announced a 10-for-1 stock split. Shares of Broadcom surged 13.5% in pre-market trading. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Wise after it unveiled a weaker outlook for annual underlying income growth. Shares of the British money transfer group slumped 14% in midday trading.
Asian markets ended Thursday trade mixed as investors assessed the Fed's decision and cooling U.S. inflation. Japan's Nikkei 225 fell for a second day, while the South Korean KOSPI surged 1% for its third straight day of gains. The Hong Kong Hang Seng Index also jumping 1%, with electric vehicle makers providing a boost. Hong Kong-listed shares of Chinese automakers jumped even after the EU slapped higher tariffs on the EV sector. Here at home, Philippine shares among the laggards, with the main index slipping back to the 6,300 level.
Very different stories this morning and in the afternoon. Earlier, we did see an initial rebound in Philippine stocks, which was in line with how regional peers trended early in the day. But eventually, profit-taking did prevail in the afternoon, and we did reverse earlier gains, bringing the market to close just about 19 points lower. I think across the different sub-indices, it was just property that managed to hold gains throughout the day. And again, this is because we're focusing on the better-than-expected CPI numbers last night. You're right. Maybe it is the mid-holiday break that explains the tepid volumes in recent days.
The leaders of both chambers of Congress meet for the first time to align their legislative priorities. House Speaker Martin Romualdez and new Senate President Francis Escudero identified amendments to the rice tariffication law as a top priority. They also discussed passing key measures relevant to the Legislative Executive Development Advisory Council, which is set to meet on June 25. But Escudero says the topic of charter change was not on the table during the meeting with Romualdez. He insists the Senate and House should coordinate better to ensure no bills are vetoed by President Marcos Jr.
Sabi ko sa kanila is, sa tagal ko sa Kongreso, bihira naman yung nabibito dapat na bill. The coordination must increase, not only between the Senate and the House, but also with the executive.
Marcos, meanwhile, urged Congress to collaborate and work closely in passing priority measures. The president says he wants to see more inclusive, responsive, and people-centered laws before year-end.
Our people are eagerly awaiting the passage of the 17 priority bills certified by LEDAC, which we will be discussing very, very soon, which, if passed and enacted, will steer our national development and improve the conditions of our fellow countrymen.